This is a replica of Kenneth Nelson's sculpture called Needle Tower, which is installed outside of the Hirshhorn Gallery in Washington, D.C. This is an example of a system which consists of islands of compression inside an ocean of tension. The compression islands are the white PVC tubes. The tension, obviously, are the strings and cables. In principle, this should not work, but you're seeing it in front of your eyes. So how does it work? It works through the virtue of pre-tensioning and the stability that's induced by systems that are pre-tensioned before they're put together. This is a project for our Introduction to Civil Engineering course. This is the first time we've done this. In fact, we didn't even practice this before we did it with the students, and that was awesome because the students got to see things not work. Figuring out how to adapt to something that's failing and then making it stronger so that it can succeed is a great example of resilience engineering. Resilience engineering is the adaptability of systems to respond to extreme and unforeseen circumstances, and then in the end make something work where before it would never have worked in the first place. Our students got to see this, experience it, they got to feel the tensions of equilibrium with their own hands. And in the end, they've got a sculpture to look at.